Hello friends, today I am going to share with you this very cute mini DIY planter made out of conch shells. When I had bought some shells for the DIY planter which I have already uploaded earlier, there were also some conch shells which were a bit larger in size, but it was broken from the top and bottom so I couldn't use it for any other purpose. So I decided to create this very cute little DIY mini planter. And this is very easy to make and you don't need too many things to make it. All you need are some conch shells and some white M-seal and some plants and soil and a little bit of paint. And this very cute planter will be ready in a jiffy. You can easily plant cacti or some succulents or some, like I have added these showy leafed plants which don't need too much nutrition. And it looks really adorable. So let's check out how I created this mini planter. So for making this planter, I have used 3 shells and this white M-seal. Take the 2 parts of the M-seal and mix it together so that it gets activated. Mix it thoroughly, and when it is properly mixed, I took the larger conch shell which was broken from the top and bottom. So I just plant where I would put the 2 smaller shells. On the top part I put one which was broken over there, so taking a little bit of M-seal, just attach the top one and press down a little bit so that it gets firmly attached to the bigger shell. And then on the lower side which was also broken, I again gave a little bit of M-seal and I attached the other shell over there as before. So press down the M-seal a little bit so that it sticks firmly to the conch shell, and then press on the other smaller shell over it and keep it pressed for some time, and you can press the extra M-seal which is all around so that it is firmly attached. And then since I didn't have any tools, I took my nail file and I pressed it inside the spikes which were coming out from the conch shell so that the M-seal sticks well with the conch shells, because I wanted a really nice bond. So once I did this, I pressed it further using my finger. If you'd like to smoothen it out, you can take a little bit of water and you can smoothen it out, but because my shell had rough edges, so I decided to leave it a little bit rustic. I didn't make it completely plain. And then once it is attached, all you need to do is allow it to dry off. Leave it for a couple of hours. After the shell dries up, I mixed a color. I used acrylic color and I made it of a similar shade as the conch shell, and I applied that over the M-seal which I had applied. So here you can see I'm just painting the M-seal so that the color matches with that of the shell. And I did that to all the areas where M-seal was visible, both on the outside and also on the inner part of the shell. And because this is acrylic color, it's not going to get damaged even if a little bit of water comes on it once it dries off. So just apply the paint all around so that it looks of the similar color. And I in fact also added some color on the black parts of the shell which were looking a little bit odd, so that the blackness reduces a little bit. And once your coloring is done, allow it to dry off completely. Once the paint dries off, even if water comes on it, it will not peel off easily. If you have some sealant or glaze, you can also add that on top of the paint to further protect it from water. But since I didn't have and I won't be pouring water all over the shell, I left it like so. So after the painting is done and it has dried up, all you need to do is take a good mixture of garden soil, a little bit of sand, garden soil and vermicompost, and using that soil I filled up the shell. And then I took a little cacti and I planted that inside, and I filled in more soil because some of the soil will definitely go down. So very carefully I filled in the the soil and I planted these little plants, one cacti and two leafy plants which had green and reddish kind of leaf. These are the show plants. So I added two stems, they will root up, and I filled it up with the soil, adding a little soil at a time and then pushing it down with the spoon so that it gets packed up properly. Make sure to press down the soil and add more soil, as the soil will be going deeper inside the shell, and repeat this process till the soil no longer goes in. And once this is done, your planter is ready. All you need to do is give the plants a little bit of water, and because it was the first time, instead of spraying, I used a container filled with water to soak up the soil inside. Then all you need to do is keep the planter in a slightly shaded area for a couple of days, and your very easy DIY planter is done. Spray water as and when required. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and thanks for watching.